without prejudice, i.e., all fundamental rights reserved. Secured by Chapter 3 of the Jamaica Constitution of 1962. Declaration of Independence 1776. All men are created equal. Ahuuakh Indian Nation in America. House of Dallas. Executor's Office, Linton O'Neill X 232-2 East Greater Portmore St. Catherine, American Island of Zamayaka, Jamaica Commonwealth. The Superior Court of Record. Public Record Number 3343. 2. The Kingston and St. Andrew Parish Court. Criminal Division. Notice and Demand Affidavit. Criminal Trespass upon Property Causing Damage and Harm. Between claimant the man Linton O'Neill X of the House of Dallas. Doing business as Linton O'Neill Dallasdom Copyright. Authorized Representative Linton Dallas AR. And Respondeat Superior. Regina and the Government of Jamaica ET. AL. For and on behalf of the true parties of interest, the men doing business as. Chief Judge, Mr. Chester Crooks. Clerk of Court and Prosecutor, Mr. Lawson. Kingston and St. Andrew Parish Court. 144 Maxfield Avenue, Kingston 10. Jamaica. Case of Reference CR 2021 CR 02005. Vicarious Liability Notice to Agent is Notice to Foreign Principal, and Notice to Foreign Principal is Notice to Agent applies. Do not ignore this legal document. To ignore this legal document will have legal consequences for the man or woman acting in the capacity as judge, prosecutor, court clerk, or clerk of court, and or police officers. Ignorance of the law is no excuse. The man known as Chester Crooks doing business as chief judge, you are hereby given notice of ownership of real and personal property administered, converted, and trespassed upon by and through your malicious issuance of an order of prosecution for the unlawful arrest and unlawful imprisonment or kidnapping of Linton Dallas AR issued by you on April 28, 2021, under force of arms, initiating trespass and fee schedule charges. See Exhibit A Superior Court of Record, Public Record 3343, as factual evidence in support annexed hereto. To the man known as Chester Crooks doing business as or acting for a service corporation known as the Government of Jamaica as Chief Judge, notice of liability is henceforth given for the administration of personal property, 45 days imprisonment, without written authority or consent, which constitute criminal trespass and fraud. Notice of liability upon trespass. I rightfully demand Mr. Chester Crooks provide the physical wedding evidence to the following, or trespass occurs. 1. Provide the obligation or contract upon which you Mr. Chester Crooks rely to authority, control or jurisdiction to enter or access my personal property without authority or consent. 2. Provide the obligation or contract that exists between Linton Dallas AR and the Service Corporation, Government of Jamaica, you work for. 3. Provide the verified claim of trespass that Linton Dallas AR has caused damage or harm to another living man or woman and or their property. 4. Provide the name of the man or woman from said service corporation, Government of Jamaica, that claim Linton Dallas AR as their property and assuming full commercial liability for the trespass. Trespass charges are set at USA. $1 million at par value per trespass per man or woman. Trespass charges increases by USA. $1,500,000 at par value for each additional trespass. Fee schedule charge USA $25 million at par value per violator. Notice of intent. Mr. Chester Crooks, you are hereby given further notice of intent to seek, commence, and criminally prosecute all those responsible under all applicable provisions and mandates of the ordained Constitution for the Union of Several States of the United States of America, and laws, Chapter 3 of the Jamaica Constitution of 1962, made in pursuance thereof, including, but not limited to conspiracy against rights and deprivation of rights under color of law. Conspiracy against rights, Public Law, June 25th, 1948, CH 645, 62 STAT 696, PUBL, 90-284, Title I, 103, A, April 11, 1968, 82 STAT 75. If two or more persons conspire to injure, oppress, threaten, or intimidate any person in any state, territory, commonwealth, possession, or district in the free exercise or enjoyment of any right or privilege secured to him by the Constitution or laws of the United States, or because of his having so exercised the same, or if two or more persons go in disguise on the highway or on the premises of another, with intent to prevent or hinder his free exercise or enjoyment of any right or privilege so secured, they shall be fined under this title, or imprisoned not more than 10 years, or both, and if death results from the acts committed in violation of this section, or if such acts include kidnapping or an attempt to kidnap, aggravated sexual abuse, or an attempt to commit aggravated sexual abuse, or an attempt to kill, they shall be fined under this title, or imprisoned for any term of years or for life, or both, or may be sentenced to death. Deprivation of rights under color of law, public law, June 25, 1948, CH 645, 62 STAT 696, PUBL, 90-284, Title I, 103, B, April 11, 1968, 82 STAT 75. Whoever, under color of any law, statute, ordinance, regulation, or custom, willfully subjects any person in any state, territory, commonwealth, possession, or district to the deprivation of any rights, privileges, or immunities secured or protected by the Constitution or laws of the United States, or to different punishments, pains, or penalties, on account of such person being an alien, or by reason of his color or race, than are prescribed for the punishment of citizens, shall be fined under this title, or imprisoned not more than 1 year, or both, and if bodily injury results from the acts committed in violation of this section, or if such acts include the use, attempted use, or threatened use of a dangerous weapon, explosives, or fire, shall be fined under this title, or imprisoned not more than 10 years, or both, and if death results from the acts committed in violation of this section, or if such acts include kidnapping or an attempt to kidnap, aggravated sexual abuse, or an attempt to commit aggravated sexual abuse, or an attempt to kill, shall be fined under this title, or imprisoned for any term of years or for life, or both, or may be sentenced to death. Notice of fault. 1. Public servants in receipt of this notice are required by their oath of office to answer. Notification of legal responsibility is the first essential of due process of law. Connolly v. General Construction Company, 269 U.S. 385,391. Silence can only be equated with fraud where there is a legal or moral duty to speak, or when an inquiry left unanswered would be intentionally misleading. U.S. v. Tweel, 550F.2D.297. It is the ministerial fiduciary/trustee duty of each and every government official, officer, agent, contractor, and assign of the United States and its instrumentalities to timely and fully answer. Federal Crop Insurance v. Merrill, 1947, 332 U.S. 380, 92 L.Ed. 10, 68 S.C.T. 1, 175 A.L.R. 1075. 2. The period for respondents to respond to this notice is 30-30 calendar days. Any party or public servants wishing to answer, respond, refute, rebut, deny, object, or protest any statement, term, declaration, denial, or provision in this presentment must do so by lawful protest within 30-30 calendar days of the date of issuance, or forever lose all rights, titles, interests, and the opportunity to plead. All such responses must be verified and have exhibitions and factual evidence in support annexed thereto. 3. Respondents may agree with all statements, terms, declarations, denials, and provisions herein by remaining silent. Failure to timely respond to all such terms and provisions with which respondents disagree comprises respondents' stipulation and confession jointly and severally to acceptance of all statements, terms, conditions, declarations, denials, and provisions herein as facts, the whole truth, correct and fully binding on all parties. 4. This document serves as notice of fault in the event respondents fail to timely respond. 5. Notice of default shall be issued no sooner than 3 days after notice of fault. Default is final 3 days after notice of fault is issued. Default comprises respondents' consent jointly and severally to be named as defendants in various actions, administrative and judicial. 6. Upon default, all matters are settled by way of arbitration. 7. Default comprises an estoppel of all actions, administrative and judicial, by respondents against Linton O'Neill Dallas TM Copyright, 3J. Pomeroy, Equity Jurisprudence Section 805, p. 192, Restatement 2D of Torts Section 894, L. 1979, and now reasonably relied on, Wilbur National Bank v. U.S. 294 U.S. 120, 124-125, 1935, due to misconduct by government agents. Heckler v. Community Health Services, 467 U.S. 51, at 59, 60, Federal Crop Insurance, Supra. It, the doctrine of estoppel by silence, arises where a person is under duty to another to speak, or failure to speak is inconsistent with honest dealings. In Re McArdle's Estate, 140 Miscellaneous, 257, ETSEQ, and silence, to work estoppel, must amount to bad faith. Wise v. USDC Kentucky, 38 F. Sup. 130, 134, where duty and opportunity to speak, Codd v. Westchester Fire Insurance Company 14 Washington 2D 600, 128 P 2D 968, 151 ALR 316, creating ignorance of facts. Cushing v. U.S. Moss S., 18 F. Sup., 83, inducing person. Claiming estoppel to alter his position, Branch v. Freaking, 219 Iowa 556, 258 NW 892, knowledge of facts and of rights by person estopped, Harvey v. Richard, 200 Law 97, 7 so. 2D 674, willful or culpable silence, Lincone v. Fidelity Trust and Savings Bank of Fresno, 96 calories, App, 490, 273 p, 103 ETSEQ, silence implies knowledge and an opportunity to act upon it, Pence v. Langdon, 99 U.S. 578 at 581, ETSEQ. Timely notice and demand has been given you. June 25, 1948, CH 645, 62 STATA07, PUBL, 103-322, Title XXXIII, 330016, 1, H, September 13, 1994. 108 STAT 2147. Certification Justice of the Peace. Testified this 22nd day of June, in the year 2021. Most sincerely. Copyright/Copy Claim June 22nd, 2021.